Geothermal energy is an eco-friendly type of energy extracted from the Earth's core, derived from the decay of radioactive elements in the Earth's crust. It can serve as an alternative to fossil fuels used to produce electricity, as well as fuel for automobiles and jets. Fossil fuels are harmful to the atmosphere, releasing large amounts of carbon dioxide, a greenhouse gas which causes air pollution. Global warfare, such as the one in Ukraine, has resulted in extremely high and volatile fossil fuel prices. With that in mind, the St. Lucia government has made the renewable energy sector project a priority. The project, which involves exploration drilling, seeks to inform the government on the viability of geothermal resource for power generation and clean energy investment. Saltibus, Belle Plaine, and Fosse-Jacques are project locations. Chairman of the Soufre Regional Development Foundation, Ernest Auger, acknowledged the urgent need for alternative energy sources.
We are all too conscious of the impact and reliance on fossil fuels. The stark reality hits us in the face in an even more alarming rate in recent times. Our small economies have been consumed in almost every aspect of the negativity associated with fossil fuel, its emissions throughout the region and in St. Lucia also.
Last year, in the midst of COVID lockdowns, energy prices rose sharply.
Many places of work, industry and leisure were all suddenly in need of more energy at the same time, putting unprecedented pressure on suppliers of energy. Prices increased again in February this year after the Russian invasion of Ukraine. Energy prices are expected to continue to increase.
World Bank officials say the unstable and high cost of electricity is an impediment to investment, and the project is seen as a solution to that problem. And Director General for Africa, Latin America and the Caribbean, Corinne Robertson, says it's no accident that approximately 80% of government's UK-funded programs have a climate adaptation and mitigation component, given the effect that climate change is having on small island developing states like St. Lucia.
And that's why the UK has been and will continue to be a key ally, I hope, for St. Lucia and for all of the SIDS when it comes to influencing the climate and finance space and helping to secure better and easier access to finance to ensure that systems and decisions take account of the special circumstances that small island developing states are experiencing.
Infrastructure Minister Stevenson King assured that best practices would be adhered to at all times during the implementation of the project.
The project to be undertaken comprises two phases of geothermal exploration activities, preparation and implementation. The preparation stage consists of design services, technical support, and the hiring of two main contractors, a civil works contractor, a drilling contractor in this phase. The implementation phase comprises both civil works and drilling works. The civil works entail access road to the drilling sites, water supply works, strengthening of bridges and the drilling of sites preparation.
Prime Minister Philip Pierre lamented the decision that top oil producers Russia and Saudi Arabia took this month to cut oil production by 2 million barrels a day.
A larger than expected cut, which took effect this month and which represents around 2% of the global oil supply and will have significant impact on the price of goods and services globally. The move is designed to boost the price of oil, which fell below US $90 a barrel from a peak of US $122 a barrel in June 2022. Higher than normal oil prices were the main factor for rising consumer prices that hit countries around the world earlier this year, including St. Lucia, pushing inflation rates to levels not seen in decades.
According to the International Energy Agency, Electricity demands is set to grow by 40 to 60% in some regions in the next 10 years. Currently, that demand is met primarily by fossil fuels. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas.